I don't know where we'd be had we not come to the Grand Ole Gospel Reunion when Charles Waller saw us 10 years ago. He saw us down there singing the only Bill Gaither song we ever sung. And he brought us up here anyway. Guys, I was thinking as we came in, first time we came up, I just, boy, I worked and worked and worked, went out and saved some money, tried to buy a couple nice shirts because I saw the way some of the cathedrals and some of these guys, how sharp everybody dressed in gospel music. So did that and took about two nights and spent hours just ironing my clothes so that I could try to appear like these heroes that we were going to see. I remember coming into the lobby one year in particular, and there walking with his wife hand in hand was Glenn Payne. And he walked up to me and he said, "Son," he said, "you look sharp." He said, "that's the way a gospel singer is supposed to look like." And it's moments like that at the Grand Ole Gospel that happen. They just don't seem to happen anywhere else. That the legends, yeah. I know it seems petty, but to look in a guy you admire as much as a James Blackwood or Hovey Lister or these Rebels quartets that we grew up around, and for them to tell you you're doing a good job, it means the world to us, and we hope to continue the heritage that they've begun for us, or whatever I was supposed to say, something like that. I'm not good at all that stuff, but... Hey, listen, a while back, the reason we're here is because a lot of people fought and died so that we can come in a room and sing about Jesus freely. And yes, they did. But a while back, an old boy in California decided he didn't like Under God in the pledge, and he tried to get them to take it out, and it didn't work. But I don't think it'll be the last time it's attempted. And when it comes to your town, that's something worth fighting for. But it inspired a couple people in Nashville to write this song. Without God in our nation, folks, we are a God-forsaken land, and we already know what that's going to be like. We've seen that on TV. But under God, America has been blessed. Listen.
Through every tree. abundance. This nation lives under God. Freedom has survived under God. We need to recognize we're depending on His goodness, indebted to His care.
The Booth Brothers, right there.